After high school, I took a couple of gap years. I looked for some courses that could help me gain the skills in developing video games, and the only one I could find was a Bachelor of Information Technology, Games and Entertainment Design at the University of South Australia. We come out with a degree with all the qualifications necessary to develop any piece of software, develop any website we want. We also get that specialisation in games, and that means a lot of art activities and a lot of business knowledge as well. The uni is very passionate about forming careers, not just getting people jobs. And so anything you do outside of uni to kind of get your name out there, they're going to support you in that. I went around to everyone I was studying with, and I said, do you want to join a game development club? We went to some networking events outside of uni and met up with some local artists, and funnily enough, they wanted to be in the club as well. And so our group doubled in size over a weekend, and it's still growing today. It's called the South Australian Game Makers Association. I got a job coordinating the Indie Games Room at AvCon, which was a massive event, 20,000 people. 40 games were on exhibition within the Indie Games Room. I was in charge of that. I got to meet a lot of fantastic names in the industry. I'm on a first-name basis with many of the game CEOs and general managers in South Australia. As part of the Games and Entertainment Design degree, you'll be able to do a course called the ICT Project, where the uni matches you up with a potential employer, and you get the opportunity to really show off your stuff. My ICT project was to develop a game controller using an emerging technology called digital foam. Universities are the place where innovation happens. I want to start my own business and develop these big games, and I feel that I have a real opportunity to do that as a part of finishing this degree. It's really given me the best sort of launch pad I could ask for.